I didn't have to. I mean, I just heard screaming from upstairs.
And then I take Minnie to play bingo, which is just really a lot of fun because in the cafeteria of an elementary school, the chairs are about big enough for a first grader, and I'm
falling over the sides.
That particular year.
Okay.
So he didn't. I mean, wasn't.
Why is it not recording anything? I cannot see.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, he's really been wound up tired of the tick this weekend. Well, we went out early this morning and flooded the side. And all that dirty old work.
Because the lens. There we are.
Yeah, you know, that's bound to help.
Dad on the phone. Okay.
Can you imagine? And he'd been drinking, he'd been playing golf, and he said, you know, everybody drinks two or three beers while they're playing golf. And he said, it just didn't feel good that day. And boy, they gave him a breathalyzer test right now. And of course, as soon as they found out he hadn't been drinking, then they were sort of leading his way. He said, the first one, he said, he thought they were going to climb all over him. He's scared to death.
Feeding the fish. Hey, babies. Food. Look at that little baby. That's my baby. Poor little ones can't get their mouth in it. Gonna explode. There you go. Where's my baby? Isn't that neat? No more dogs. Want a dog. If you had a dog, there'd be a cute little dog sitting in that little dog house. John Mandy, I love you. I love you. Looks like you're putting in a sidewalk.
Yeah, that too.
Have we taken the camera out and shown everything that we've done in the backyard? Like the stuff down the side?
I don't think so.
Well, let's just move over this way. This is what we do.
This is our little project. There's a lot of dirt. Most of it's on Carolyn's knees. But we just finished all the real nasty part, putting the forms in. Are we fishing? You're supposed to go like this.
I'm trying.
We're draining the fish pond. We haven't seen the fish in about 3 days, 5 days.
It's real green.
Got real cold, chilly, and they disappeared, so we don't know if they're dead or not. And the water's real, real green, so we figure we'll make sure they're in there and scrub it out and put them some new water in there.
And this is what we have been doing.
This is what, the fourth weekend?
Uh-huh.
Took all the sod out, chopped all the roots all the way around the sidewalk place, put our form in, filled it with sand yesterday. That makes it sound awful easy, doesn't it?
Yeah. All you got to do is...
We got lots of blisters and sore knees off of this. And now we're packing the sand down, watering it, watering it, watering it, and packing it down. And the bricks come next week, and we're going to brick the sidewalk part, and on the inside part is going to be lots and lots of ivy. We just got all the water out of it and hosed it all out and vacuumed it out with the wet dry vac. And we got all the fish in buckets and coolers. We're just hoping this isn't too terribly traumatic for them. So we have to fill it up and then pour chemicals in it to kill the chlorine and then throw them back in there.
And we didn't get dirty at all, did we?
Not even mud city. Watch this.
See,
can you see the mud?
See the little fish splatter when they get caught.
And that mud is like not regular kind of mud, is it?
It's nasty. Nasty.
It's called fish mud.
Slime.
Yeah, I noticed it doesn't wash off your hands real well.
No. That's pretty good having two hoses doing that.
Yeah, and Russell's got a lot more pressure than we do.
You sure does, don't you?
Yeah, we'll have that pull in 20 minutes, I'll bet. You think?
Yeah. Start the fountain.
Hmm?
Let's start the fountain.
Oh, wait, stop. Cut it off. There she blowed. Here, I'll just keep the camera on so I can get a picture of you getting
through the muck.
Hosed. Well, you got those high top. Okay.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yes, look here. Look here. Is that cute?
It's not tight at all.
Huh?
It's not tight at all. Maybe...
Wiggle it and push it down.
Okay.
You got it. That's all down all the way now.
Mm.
Nice feet. Look up close here. Nice.
That's awful.
Damn, you're going to have to wear socks in bed tonight.
Oh, yuck.
Dirty pigs. Dirty pigs.
I'll try it again.
Now she's blowing.
Oh, that's pretty, isn't it?
I've never seen white water come out of that before. Always got to be playing with that hose. Now you're going to get the water all dirty if you wash that off.
The chlorine.
Oh, you always resort to knowing more about chemicals than I do, and then I can't argue with you. Huh?
I'm done now.
Boy, that thing really, look at it go.
Yeah, it's going good, isn't it?
Yeah. That's one of them six, one of those for an 11-foot person, one of them blue days, ain't it? Woo-hoo-hoo. Well, this fish won't, they'll think, good Lord, we must have been issued contact lenses when they get back in. It would be so clear. Now, doesn't it bug you to see just a little tiny leaf floating around in there?
It sure does.
This is how long it takes to do this, about 3 hours?
Oh, did it take that long? I hope not. This fish
probably two. Probably two.
That long.
Should you be putting the chemical in now and letting it circulate?
Yeah, I was actually debating the merits of having the chemical, the chlorine hit the stuff and kill it first,
mm-hmm.
or go ahead and put it in and what do you think? It's gonna get them anyway, right? I mean, it's gonna get the slime anyway.
Well, if the chlorine's gonna kill the stuff, why don't you just let it go?
Okay.
There's a great big leaf floating over there.
I see it. I'm going to
get it right now. Okay. We'll get this recorded. So we know that there's no leaf in there. Ah, we're leafless.
Well, we found two of Sarah's dog coins in there.
Yes, we did. We found the old Frisbee, and we found something that looked like a little floating bomb. What was that?
That was a little blue sweet toy. Remember?
Blue. Was it blue?
Yeah, it was blue.
Get in there with it.
I'll have to take that to Rosemary next time.
And this little thing has been a back-breaking son of a gun. But probably the most fun thing we've ever done. Because it is going to look like real neat. Down there in the corner, where there's a triangle of dirt, we're going to bring those same azaleas around right along the sidewalk and make a just like a little enclosed place in here. I don't think we've taken any pictures of our new azaleas, have we?
No, because we have.
About two months ago, we did this whole side over here, put 79 new azaleas in, put new sprinklers in for them, and they have grown like crazy, fertilized the fool out of them.
Cards, America. Uh-huh. What do you have?
Closer look at
gosh.
You little mole.
You have one. Yeah, like that's a real problem for you. For that big point.
Okay.
Skink was at the back.
I know. And Fool.
And Fool was bad. To this day, I don't want anybody calling me a fool. Sure, I like to do that, and voice and stuff that real quick.
I think that was my
thing.
Yeah. I've always hated that. That's sort of the ultimate foot
in there. Somebody stupid. I can just take it for that. Or a liar.
Yeah.
Yeah, you wouldn't
let
Charlie
call you a
liar.
And yell, shut up.
Mm-hmm.
There's just some basic rules of just don't treat people that way. Can't you figure out stink? But is it pew?
I just got puffed on you.
Is that why?
I'm sure it is. No one ever said that, but I'm sure it is.
Oh my God.
If your maiden name was Pew, wouldn't you be sort of having an aversion towards the word stink, as if maybe a lot of people called you that?
Oh my God, that would, I mean, but the shocking thing is that would carry over to adulthood.
Mm-hmm.
That would bother me enough not to, let, not with,
Blondie. Anytime someone says partridge, in a pear tree.
Most people say they want
family. Most people say partridge family.
Old people say in a pear tree.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's very clever.
Yeah,
I never thought of that.
Well, the best one was the pizza guy came up. Said, "Hey, no trouble finding your house. Just look for the big colorful bus parked outside." That was real funny.
That one. God, Don, this is wonderful. We didn't have any lunch today, did we?
No. There's some more food inside. Who thinks that extra number?
I'll leave you there. No one else. 1 second.
We just go over there?
Sure. Yeah, we didn't eat lunch. We deserve 8 pieces of corn, you see?
Put your corn stove in here.
I'm sorry? Okay.
I don't want all of that. I need all of it.
All of what?
That burger.
That's fine. I'll eat the rest of it. And listen, that goes for everybody. If you have anything that will be all you there.
That's a given.
Thanks.
Mm.
Now what do we do about the koi he's doing this crap?
We don't
can't do anything.
They're no better than any of the rest of them.
Oh, come on.
Is that who we were trying
you know
to
what makes
say?
Them better? Mm-hmm. What makes them better?
Mm-hmm.
They invest in us.
Mm-hmm. They got the bucks.
They got something. They got the bucks in us.
They got what we want.
It's the only reason we have. They are doing what they're doing. If you have anything close to Palestine or Iraq,
mm-hmm.
put you out of the country. They interviewed one guy. I read the paper a couple days ago. This guy is like Palestinian or maybe an Iraqi, but he has lived in Kuwait almost all his life. He married a Kuwaiti. He has children that grew up in Kuwait, and they booted them all out. He said,
"Kuwaiti lady,
I have spent my entire life building this country." He said, "I have done nothing but serve this country my entire life." He said, "What is the deal?" And they just don't say anything. They just ship them right across the border and say, "Don't come back."
Sad.
He says, "You don't understand. We're going to be killed by Saddam Hussein." They don't care. The biggest, at first I didn't think this, but right now I think the biggest, sorriest thing about that entire ordeal is that we did not Saddam Hussein out. Why didn't we do that? Why didn't we do that? Does anyone understand that?
I think politically, our only announced goal was to get them out of Kuwait. It was not to remove them from power. That wasn't part of it.
That's
so, like, we don't do that.
No.
We will fight him again then.
Mm-hmm.
He still has an army of 300,000.
Mm-hmm.
We killed and captured all of his worst armies, I think.
People, they're just, like, surrendering to it. They got out of their tank. I tell you, I was on the news in Greenville.
Why?
There's, like, a peace rally behind our dorm. Like, on the mall.
Are you rallying for peace?
I just went out there to see what was going on.
What would you say as a innocent bystander?
They said, if you were president, what would you do for the situation?
I would not spend any money on anything outside the country for about 15 years.
That's another good idea.
Are we sending money to countries that can't help us at all?
Well, there was a peace rally, and the last thing I said was Saddam Hussein needs to die. Luckily, you couldn't hear me.
And also, you used to grumble, and all these people come over and just pop on Andy into the dirt.
Yeah, you couldn't even hear what I was saying on TV. Because there was a band playing really loud. People I didn't even know would walk by. So, you don't hear me.
Mandy would say,
what? What is it?
Can I have a tomato and a lettuce,
please? I need a tomato. You're going to want corn, so I'll go and get it.
Oh. I don't think so.
I was corned out. Everybody corned out?
I may, just as a little, you know, a little end of the meal teaser.
Right. Where did this fork come from? This one was a pickle fork. I brought it. There's an extra fork I could have used. Which wasn't you? It was you.
Pickle peaches.
Let me see your neck, you.
They go like this.
Wow, you want to see my steak?
I just want to say, I thought you had a big booger in your nose first, but let me say. I mean, does it ever poke the inside of your nose?
When I go like that, yeah.
Every time I get hit.
Every time I go.
She was going to ask Betsy to take it into the store and have it cleaned.
I did. She's already asked her.
Really?
She didn't tell her it was her nose ring. She said, I have a little loop earring. She goes, yeah, give them to me. I said, well, it's just one. Can I
see
your napkin?
I mean,
slip it on it. I don't care.
What are you going to do with it?
I'm going to wipe off my floor.
First off, you want to think again. Can you imagine being a poor little guy who works in that place
and cleaning nose rings?
Just as he finishes, someone says, hey, that's Manny Partridge's nose ring. And they go, what? Because he's been taking it and going like this.
I need to get it clean because it's got like a little hinge on it.
It's like booger encrusted.
Full of nose jam.
Mike, we were standing out of someplace.
First off, before I forget, how long have you had it?
Right? Manny and I were in Sam's, getting tired from the truck. Some young kid came up and he's taking care of us and all that kind of stuff, and it's real hot. It's a little white thing in the corner of his mouth. We get about 10 feet away, Manny.
Both quarters are in the
mouth. You need to attend to that lip cheese.
Get
on that lip cheese, homie.
Let's do it, Mikey.
Has everyone had all the peaches they want?
No. Yeah. No, I'm done. You haven't had anything? Oh, I'm sorry.
But not two.
I'll take that last peach. Those are good. Every time I eat French peaches, I get this like pain in my stomach. I'm not used to them. It's rarely that I eat French peaches. But I don't care,
I'm getting it. Even first thing in the morning, nothing else.
God, I'll kill you. Peaches?
Yeah, for
really?
Some reason, I don't know why I don't feel bad.
Boy, I never even heard anybody.
I mean, upsets my stomach like terrible. Boy, I bet you're excited.
You're too good, though.
I'm glad I asked for two burgers, they were awesome.
Barely.
Yeah, I couldn't have done it on one. That's real good. Why isn't that thing not squirting besides these things?
It's not
clean. The filter is kind of goopy.
Goopy. Mm.
What? How many gallons an hour on that, with that head on there?
I don't know because I don't know if that head restricts it.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Even when it's boiling, I mean, it really does well.
Totally. But is it rated at 700 gallons an hour at a 4-foot head?
He's ready to step. Didn't you see that list of pumps I showed you? It says some of downs at this amount of head.
We were all just so hungry.
I kind of imagine that unrestricted supplement. But I feel sure that it would pump 500 gallons in an hour, pump that whole thing.
Cigarettes and dental floss. I went back into a reggae wear today.
Did you?
And she was like, your mom's really nice. I was like, if you met my real mom, you wouldn't say that.
It has something fun. Don't buy them there. It's expensive. Just put it in Raleigh. Has the best school selection.
All right. The worst.
Brick wall of leaves. The abominable brake man. Hey Joey. Hey, can you wave at me? Joey.
I didn't lock, I just pulled it shut. I don't know if it locked or not.
Okay. I doubt it is.
Joey. Joey.
Get in the picture, Sophie. No, no. Got it. Thing. Can you hide underneath them?
They can.
You got a door and everything. You got that for a birthday.
I don't think they even look.
so night-night. Jackie looks like a big one. Getting out of his pants. With a stony hanging around. Oh!
You want a little bit more height here? Yeah,
a little bit more height. To the top! Okay, you jump over here.
Do something wonderful, Ann.
What?
Do your most wonderful trick.
Huh?
Do your most wonderful trick. That's good. That's good.
I did that very well.
Slow down a little bit. Okay?
I guess I can show you my double chin.
You want to do it again?
You're up there real tall. Run. Rock. She run into something before coming down here?
Yeah.
Oh, she ran to bed.
She turned over.
Oh.
Got a place on her side. That's
why you shut the door?
You buckled up for safety?
Outside, baby.
Because he didn't mind it a bit, does he?
Ah!
Don't hurt me. What are you doing?
You're staying on this side, Joey.
Ben, what are you going to do with your van?
I have to get it fixed.
Still not fixed?
Don't you have some people?
Yeah, that's a good idea. I need to move it.
Where to?
I just want to move it over where the traffic's around here.
Okay.
Oh,
you're
stuck. Look at that thing up all by itself.
It has no little shoes on today.
Bang. Do you want me to go get it?
Yeah, let's watch Aunt Ann. Go do it.
What'd you say?
Where is the ladder? At the cabin here? Yeah.
Do you want me to get the frisbee?
Let's go get you the tissue.
Thanks, sweetheart.
Race for another run,
5-1. Yahoo! No, I want you to put it in Mama's key. That's it?
Yeah.
No. Right here. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Right. Yeah.
We're going to become members of the Virginia Cattlemen's Association.
and have a sticker on our truck.
And what else? Oh, the Virginia Nurse Ribbons Association.
Uh-huh.
And Horsemen's Association.
Yes, right, Horsemen's.
Mostly the Horsemen's Association. That, as far as when we put the stickers on the truck, that'll be on time.
Hi, Dave. That's Dave. There's Bob. Say hello, Bob. There's Vicky, your cousin Vicky. Cousin Vicky doesn't like her picture taken, so we'll go somewhere else. Where's Fane? She used to be right there. There's Fane.
No.
Ann, what are you doing? Over where? Where?
Just sit up right on top.
Alright, I got you one. Here's your sandwich.
Here now.
Little Fane. Okay.
Mama.
There's Jay. And her new little baby Nathan.
This looks like a herd of sheep with all these little babies.
It sure
little sheepies running around.
And these are Daryl's daughters, and their names are Elizabeth and Curry. Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Aren't they cute?
And there's Elva's husband Gary, Uncle Alan. And there's Dave again. Uncle Bernard.
If anyone's missing, they're
Uncle Bernard and Dave watching the crowd.
I know, I'm Jay.
If anyone's missing, you can pick up on the other side of the house having babies.
Where'd you
burn? Can we get everybody?
Well, that's a lens of the place you put food in.
Pretty there, you sitting on the end of that thing.
Mama!
Joey!
Mama!
Oh, you mean the cat just came.
Wave day.
Hear what she said.
What's that? Modern day English.
This is Mike doing what he does best. Speak for itself. Ooh. Can you throw it to me, Joe? Joe's getting all the time here.
Okay. Okay, I'm ready. Okay. Kick it hard. Woo!
That's what I've been working on for Christmas, February.
Mm-hmm.
We go to Charlotte in February and get that lumber.
Mm-hmm.
And I haven't worked on it every minute, but it's kind of hard to work in there in the summertime when it's real hot. When you have a great big stomach and you don't have a shirt on and the sawdust gets stuck on your stomach. No fun.
Carolyn, get it off. I'm itching all over.
So, let's see. You've been working on it feverishly for the last 3 weeks. And it's just now done.
See the pretty feet? We're going to get close up to the feet.
Feet.
And the detailed molding across the bottom.
And it's going to go beside our bed upstairs.
And the trim in the drawers.
And then the very
the top,
very next thing is going to be a chest on chest. And the top piece of it is going to be just about like that, only a little wider. And the bottom piece is going to be like real big, like 3 inches wider on either side, so 6 inches wider. And it's like a humongous chest of drawers. But that's going to be walnut. And
that's real pretty.
So this is the first day of daylight savings time, and it's only 10 after 9 in the morning, and we're already wide awake. It's pretty amazing. And we're going to go get cleaned up and go horseback riding. And then I'm going to go relax and rest a little bit, and Carolyn's going to go rake thousands of bags of pine straw. And the fish won't come up this morning.
Are they still sleeping, I guess? Are they coming?
I haven't seen them. There they go. There they come. They're real skittish, though.
Yeah, they were skittish yesterday, too. There they go.
But they eat like crazy right now.
Getting all fat for the winter.
The little ones are always the first ones to come. Yeah, well, they grab and run. Those big fat ones won't come out.
That's pretty dull.
You want to get a rear shot?
Oh, that is so bad.
Okay, wait.
Don't make him fall down.
Sure is Mandy's trick. And on some great big ones, they would fall out of here. It's either that was real funny. Who's that comedian who said, you can always tell how old a man is
about how high it wears his pants. And a real old man, you can count the rings that grew up here, and eventually they're up around his neck. As he sits with his head on his stomach.
What a trick.
Yeah. Not all of us can do that. That's very uncomfortable. And these are little flowers. First time they've bloomed like this, because Russell cut this tree way out and let some sunlight in. And they're blooming like crazy. So Russell put in, what is that right there?
Gardenia.
Sasanqua, gardenia. And they put in all kinds of bushes in here. Weekend before last. And planted his ryegrass, and it came up like cat hair.
Okay, it's recording now.
Well, I was just trying to tell Scotty what I was doing, and this is what I'm doing. And it's going to be very much like the one in the kitchen, except it's out of spruce, and it's going to look real old when I get done. And these are the three shelves that go in it, and I've started the door, and that's going to be the most fun part, because it's going to be as decorative as I can do, and that just takes some thought. And all this morning I have been making moldings, and I made, this was already on there, I didn't do that this morning, but I made this piece, and this piece, and the way this will go is, like that.
Very pretty.
And go up in there like that. But for right now, I've been working on the bottom, and I got this cut, and it's fit, so the next thing I'm going to do is put it on there, and then the next piece of molding goes on top of it, just like on the top, goes on there like that. And it takes 3 minutes to make the molding, and it takes 3 hours to make these little cuts on the edges to go around this corner. And you got to take off just a little teeny weeny bit, because it's real easy to take it off, but it's real hard to put it back on. And I got some new toys since you were here.
The early Christmas presents.
Okay, you want to see something sand, something really wild.
A scratch piece of wood?
Yeah, I got some right here.
Got it.
And it works real quick. That'll do something in like 15 seconds more faster than I could do it in an hour by hand. And I made this router table.
Lovely.
And the router is mounted up underneath right there with a spindle sticking up.
Mm-hmm.
And make all kinds of molding and all kinds of neat stuff on that. And I got a new joiner planer that will also ease your fingers off to your elbow before you know what happened. And that just makes things real unbelievably straight on the edge of boards, so that you can put them together and they line up real well. And this is last year's Christmas present.
Mm-hmm.
And it's wonderful. And I can easily live out here, as long as I have plenty of lumber. You also notice there aren't nearly as many trees around since I got all this new stuff. And that's what I've been doing, making dust. And since I figured out a byproduct of what I'm doing right now with all the spruce, I make gerbil shavings, gerbil chips. So we'll have a tractor trailer load going out of here soon. Bag them up, ship them out. And that's what I do. Settle down. Terribly excited. And already got a next project lined up. Chest on chest, like this tall. It's like two great big dressers. One goes on top of the other, fits on it real neatly, with like 8 or 10 drawers. And that'll take some real time, like maybe a couple months, but it'll be real pretty. And 2 or 3 other little things planned to do. And that's it. Hamster. We're going to see the world's largest hamster. It was just discovered in Wilmington. Oh, golly, I don't want to get too deeply in here. We'll never get out, will we? Ever. Yeah. Wow.
We'll park right behind the building?
Yeah.
Maybe. Bad. We take their five fish and cherries and parmesan. Yum. Pea? I want a pea. Gosh, she gets the best green beans. What kind of green beans are those?
We have tomorrow. They're really peas.
They're what?
They're really peas in the pods. What do they call them? Snap peas.
We're peas in the pods. God, I'm really good at them. It's amazing. Bears.
Crumpet monkey.
10 least favorite automobile, what do you call them? What are they?
Options.
Options. Intermittent steering.
I think I've heard that one.
Hydraulic roadkill scoop.
Maybe you can read that one to us, you're like, it's hard.
I think that's the best way to enjoy that book, is have someone who laughs funny sit and read it to you, because they read it and then they, Manny goes into absolute sniff on the sofa.
Wheezing.
I think the top 10 for Jack Klugman is my all-time favorite.
For what?
Jack Klugman.
Jack Klugman.
Quincy. Television, the guy who played the corner.
You know, the odd couple. Tony Randall and Jack Klugman. Kind of ugly guy.
Big nose.
Okay, so what were they?
Well, Klug, Klugger, Klugmeister.
I'm the hamster.
Peanut. Captain. Captain was like the number one.
And
I think in the book, Captain. I think in the book they said Peanut was the last one, but I know that I waited for Captain because that's the only one they can wait for. And it's just so anticlimactic. I mean, you had all these, you had the Klugmeister, I just thought everybody's gonna lose it.
Top 10 least favorite, or least appropriate, grocery store names, Larva Town, expiration date grab bag.
Well, step back.
Who is the little awful fat guy with the black glasses, black wandering glasses?
Bud Melman
is an advisor. People call in, people ask questions out of the audience, and he advises them about their love problems.
What is his question?
I have a boyfriend out of state. I wonder, what can we do to keep the relationship going?
What he said?
Introduce a bisexual interstate trucker.
To keep both of you happy. I'm just throwing it.
Oh my god, that is incredible.
And he's sitting there with no expression on his face whatsoever, was looking around like,
oh, what's up, honey? Whatever his laugh is. Can you do the laugh? You know what I'm talking about?
It's like, I can hear it in my mind, though I can't make the sound, though.
You have to have a face to go with it.
Also,
that little mouth in there.
Before he answers each question, he has to have a drink of, white wine?
Chablis! Can I have some Chablis, please?
Did you see inside Cecil's, you didn't go in the store at all, did you?
Just to talk to him, briefly.
Did you see what his coolers looked like?
I went in there.
Did you see him?
I don't remember.
I know she had a lot of Coke machines. Open the door to control codes.
Who's Cecil?
Four out of those five were stocked to the top with beer, and the other two were just like, a little bit of Vago or something like that. It was just pitiful, but this was all stocked, and I'm very tempted. Poppy cool, but I didn't.
This black guy on MTV Comedy Hour last night. Have you ever been making love to a woman and she started hyperventilating? Can I just perform the Heineken maneuver?
Heineken?
I didn't know what to do, I just got a beer.
Where? Did you hear this?
On MTV.
Oh my god, that's hilarious.
Gary Jones said something about
so
He thought he'd given his girl a 30-minute orgasm, and then he found out she had epilepsy.
He's the worst.
But that was another conversation.
This is my Friday account movie.
Yeah, we've been taping all of this wonderment.
I like your sweatshirt.
Thank you, that was a gift from my office along with Mom.
So you have to wear that to work every day?
Mm-hmm. It's a uniform now.
That's why I'm summer having to cut sleeves out.
Yeah. Get up!
My flavor dimmer.
My glass. My germs.
It's so good.
Good. This is very good.
We have one more. Mike, have you seen one of our bills?
Bob.
Well, I know everyone's seen one about Bob. Have you seen one about Bill?
What's up, Father Bride?
You know what I'm taking that about?
You were with us when we went to see it.
Well, I don't remember.
We were right here. It was last time I was here.
Yeah.
Well, who couldn't be expected to remember something that long ago? My God, it's been 3 weeks.
I know where I get it from.
Uh-huh.
You do that too?
Do you remember? Oh, no, that wasn't you.
No, I never catch myself. People always have to tell me.
Just what I did, blah, blah, blah.
I was
there.
You.
It is really good.
I bet you could hear something like that.
Pizza Hut at Morrison's cafeteria, not me.
Pardon me?
Pizza Hut at Morrison's cafeteria.
Or nachos.
Oh, jeez. Probably not that bad.
7 years ago tonight, we saw. 7 years ago tonight. We were in Jacksonville, Florida, and that 7 years ago tonight, that woman turned upside down her nachos.
That's sure what
you're
talking about.
That's what you're talking about.
Nachos. What do you say, some Eddie Murphy movie?
Photos, Cop? That's something real funny.
You wanted to take to see that.
Huh?
Remember when, you took me and Karen and Missy to Bennigan's and then not see that? And Karen had all those huge hickeys all over her neck.
What?
Karen had like hickeys like that. I mean, just. I don't know how that could have happened that way, but they did.
12.
Are you sure it wasn't leprosy or something like that?
No, it's called Tall Gimbal.
It's called who?
Tall Gimbal. This is EOP!
Christmas song
is so beautiful.
Am I gonna like the Bobbies?
Ball beans. You know that little, okay, you know the trays at Forest Hills when you're little? Had the like little pocket in the side for your little instruments of eating stuff, you know?
Bailey.
Well, it had like a little scoop down little trench. Yeah. This was our.
What was that?
Our bowling alley.
I don't remember that.
That's what me and Helen used to do.
Oh, I remember the first day I ate there. Oh, this is so good. First day I ate there, second grade. Finished my lunch, but it wasn't quite finished. I had my bag left. You know, what do you do with an empty paper bag? Boom! And it was the table that was right up next to the cash register.
Miss Missing!
You learned a lesson on the first day real quick with the salt shaker. Jesus, H. Christ, I thought I was going to throw my entire lunch up.
If we were too loud, she would come up and take the salt shaker and bang it on the table. Guess who I saw today? Miss Lawson, you remember our music teacher? And she would talk like this!
In Forest Hills?
Yeah.
You are joking me. Where did you see her? How would you recognize her?
She was exactly the same. Got no eyelashes, no eyebrows, big pink lips.
Big liver lips.
Something liver lips.
Big pink lips. I can't believe I forgot all that. actually certainly raise her voice up, wouldn't she?
But she would talk in one note and sing it. When she taught us Doe a Deer.
If you saw her today, how old is she?
I don't know, but I have to, like, write down everybody's birthday when they write checks. Mm-hmm. It's weird. Every time I see a date, I try to figure out how old they are.
Usually this doesn't work, though, does it? Mm-hmm.
It is.
Well, how old was she born? 1894?
I don't remember.
Yeah, she was funny. So there was something about her that she would be mean every once in a while. It was really weird. What did she do that was so bizarre? There wasn't it something that something little tiny would just throw her. Oh, it was when she brought the recorders in.
What are those things called?
Auto harp.
I always try to call them harpsichord. I played one of those in the Thank You for the Music, the songs I sing. Don't you remember that?
No.
You don't remember we used to go to the Hanover Gymnasium, whatever that gymnasium was. Everybody would have. At the music festival. I think Bell was here. No, I mean,
oh, wait a second. Was it the symphony?
It was like all the kids from all the schools would like play those little dumb instruments.
We didn't do that there, I don't think. We did some
else. We did watch them play, but when we all played like one song together or something like that.
Was that what it was? We all played one song together.
Yeah. But it was like a whole day affair kind of thing.
Oh,
I remember those.
They were the best. I was up there keeping the rhythm, keeping everything together.
Well, you were the glue, weren't you?
Oh, yeah. I mean, I was like...
One and a two.
I was like Bill Murray.
I need.
Now, I remember the neatest thing was every year they would send us for the whole day to the symphony, and supposedly they didn't have enough money or they weren't going to be able to fit it in or something, and you would think naturally they would say, well, you know, that you've seen the symphony 3 years already, you know, we're just going to do the symphony. They said, no, well, these kids have seen the symphony all the way through. They're only going to see it a couple more years, so we'll let them see it. They won't be able to see it. And I was just like, they won't know. It was really nice. Why? I mean, it was like an entire city.
It was 3 years.
Every little kid in New Hanover County was there at the same time.
Mm-hmm. Playing or listening?
Both.
Playing just like us, one song, I think. We always had to learn one song before. I remember the only one I can really remember we had. It was a whole thing about blue whales. Did you go see that one?
Mm-mm.
That was really neat. I had a huge sculpture of a blue whale out in front of Brighton Hall when you walked in.
You mind moving these? You want yelps?
Yeah, I'll take those in the corner.
Okay. No, really, you want these, Jack? I think his character is divine.
Hey! Oh, did I just grind it in my skin, you butthead?
You burn.
More battery? You need?
I was just about to get it.
Let me just bring it in here, I'll look for shit.
All right.
Thank you.
That's a very formal Christmas dinner.
Huh.
More dog, more Peking duck, Gatorade.
Peace. Oh, those are awesome.
Mm-hmm.
What?
got like this foil on your hand. You got foil on your hands. It's like, it's deadly. It's really thick. Mm-hmm. And when you're trying to fold it, it'll poke you. And we have these gloves that nobody uses. But I did today for a little bit. It felt so weird. I had to take it off.
Are you cutting hands? Hands are just coming in.
Well, they come in and then the back. They slice them and then glaze them. You know how they glaze them?
No, hold on a second. Let me finish this.
Well, I mean, you know, you put the glaze on your bacon.
I know what you mean. Hold on.
They have, like, big bowls of sugar and big bowls of some kind of brown spice stuff. And I have a blowtorch.
You gonna suck her out?
No.
Dump it on there, you know, it's like, it's scary, and it stinks, and it's weird, and it's just weird.
Sounds like there's probably a safer way of doing that, probably not more fun, right?
I'm sure that the flavor is already cooked into the ham, and that's just for the pretty, right?
Well, actually, it tastes good, too, but...
Yeah.
Some of them enough,
and so some of the wax came off.
Who's your young project? I
know what I got in the class.
Looks like Dad does too. Well,
Ara.
You got an Ara?
Ara?
From Remedial?
No, what is it called? I got a.
Redo?
No, it's a UG, a U, an S. What was other than. We just get U's and UG's. No, G's and UG's. Unusually good, good, satisfactory. What was the grade that we would get that we'd get total for?
An N.
An
N. What is an N? Need improvement?
Oh, I came about that far from convincing them that it meant nice. But it was printed right up below it. In not satisfactory.
Oh,
well, you was just simply unsatisfactory.
No, you was. Oh, wait.
You was an N scale.
Oh, but then there was UG and then G.
And then. No, we never had that. We just had S, N, or U. Satisfactory was
snoo.
So what did you get?
Whatever they assigned N's in, generally I got N's in. Really. In high school, I had this government teacher who class.
Micah?
No, that was.
Even in high school, you didn't get A's, B's, and C's?
No.
Okay, alright.
For,
I'm sorry.
For
I'm
all the grades. But the conduct and my citizenship came all handwriting and something else you would just get.
Yeah, you know, the
essays, interviews
about.
On. And first semester of my 11th grade year, I mean, I was rocking on the grades and this government class that everyone has to take, and it's not going to be real hard. You know, I had the best grade in the whole class. It was just too easy. So naturally, I spent the time I had free just totally raising hell. And I got my report card back and said, government, A, exceptional performance. Comments, citizenship, U. Got the best grade in class, and I had a U in conduct. She gave like a lot.
He wasn't the only one. Everybody was acting up.
No, a couple of other people did get UGs. Mark Wagner, Dirty Wags got
cut PCs in that, in conduct.
What?
You used to get PCs in that course, under conduct. Psychopathic communist.
In government.
What is Mark Wagner doing?
We saw Mark Wagner, didn't I?
You're kidding me.
David's, like last week, wasn't it?
David's?
Yeah.
Kelly?
Mm-hmm. You don't go to David's without me.
Why don't you go to David's, period, with the flies?
Oh, they did it over. Cleaned up right.
Larva Town.
How
did
you
happen to go
with that
movie? Remember
that
time we sneaked out?
Yeah. Maybe it was before.
Denied.
That was lunch.
Lunch?
Lunch.
Lunch?
Yeah.
No, it wasn't. We have been on the daylight.
Okay. We have been in the daylight.
What was that?
We're nocturnal eaters.
I don't know, my
internal feeder.
Ooh, what? Tell you about the rabid raccoons in New Jersey.
Do that?
Oh, no, you're kidding.
Yeah, my friend Rob, they used to live down in Cobb Run where he lives. He lives around all these woods.
I ate there one
night. Yeah, like
night,
raccoons come out at night. There's
home,
something
and
in there.
You and I ate there the next night. So what was the occasion?
I knew you knew that. But, like, they have rabies and they'll come out in the day and attack people.
That's possible.
Did you know they also have a parasite that is a brain parasite in humans?
What do you mean?
It comes in your ear.
In the fecal matter. And just on them, I think. I don't know if it's just on them, but I know it's in their fecal matter.
My friend Carissa used to have raccoons.
Did she ever eat any? Couldn't lick me?
Oh, the guys did
it. So it
Coon Dookie. Coon Pods.
Coon Pods.
What did David tell her about? Something in there about animal duty identification? What was that?
A Boy Scout merit badges that were not.
Yeah.
Fire shitting.
Oh. There are quite a few people who were recipients of that one.
Animal
Stuart Scoble, remember that kid? Remember that absolute
clips out and just cut it down there.
We got a beautiful cake in there, don't we?
Yes, we do.
Have you all seen
it? I get to eat the letters.
I get the cookie on top. I get the top with 3/8 of an inch.
It's a joke. The letters are paper, okay?
Dad. Well, they must be having their Christmas tonight.
Are they?
Who? Yeah, because Betsy had us bring it home.
Are they having their presents for Christmas Eve?
I don't know.
So did he see you bring it
that's
in?
That's an idea.
No,
Maine's never thought of that before.
What? What an awful idea.
Having your presents on Christmas Eve.
You haven't thought of that before?
Let's open our presents tonight. We'll just tell my kid we didn't even give him there. He said things like that. You did.
Did not.
Let's open up my kid's box.
Would y'all go snooping for your presents?
I never had. She'd be like.
Did you, Mandy? I found them all. I knew everything was right. No, I knew I was getting a dollhouse.
How do you know? My God, I worked for 8 months every night. Up to 4 o'clock in the first day. Dad,
Dad,
make it
good. Aren't you heard of a keyhole?
Oh, my God.
Oh, man.
I think you did know that, Dad.
Almost. 16 years of total bliss, and I thought I really pulled it off.
I thought I made it.
Thought I made it in this world.
Let's see if you got an encyclopedia.
I know the really Christmas of the blood.
It's pretty good. Mikey already read them. I read them.
Mikey got an encyclopedia, but Mandy got a dollhouse.
That she already knew about.
That was taller than me. It was great.
I never expected anything. I never saw him coming.
Mikey was a wonderful. I never expected anything. He would just go out and get like 8-10 part-time jobs and buy everything for him, but never expected.
I never expected anything from anybody else, of course. And,
always wonderful.
No, I never expected to buy.
And you don't know what I want yet?
He could not have held down those 8 jobs if it hadn't been for the wings on his back that he'd fly from one job to another.
We thought this was so funny when I told you I already got your present, but I haven't told you what I wanted.
Yeah. Because I decided that I was going to wait until you told me what you wanted before I went and got you something, Melonhead.
But you already did tell me, ages ago.
What do you mean you got me something? I haven't told you I wanted to.
Every right to say that.
That was hysterical.
I haven't even given you the model number.
What are you doing?
I never saw the bike coming. I didn't expect that.
No, you better not have known about that bike.
What, the 10-speed?
That was the third mortgage on the house for that dude.
Didn't know that. I really didn't know anything about the encyclopedias.
God, it's just a lucky thing that you didn't catch on to that, because you would have just been all cluttered.
It was just completely blown, you know.
That was when bicycles cost $69.
How much do they cost now?
They're awful now. But that's when a normal bicycle was like $69.
That's how much that's?
No, that was $149.
Yeah, I was going to say, I was well over $100, I remember.
Yeah.
We'll get to the time.
That one in the attic. That was in the attic.
It was?
Mm-hmm.
What happened to it?
Brought it back downstairs for Christmas morning. Remember?
Pardon me.
I was telling Carolyn the other day, we're standing out on the front porch, and I remember that morning, like, I'm standing there. It was real warm, just like it is right now, but it's real damp. All the windows, you know, and you had a blue jacket on, and you could hardly wait to get over to Philip to show him your bicycle. And actually, it wasn't showing bicycle, but showing how much it cost. And you were so little, and had the seat down all the way, and you could still just barely, in fact, the pedal would disappear from your foot, and you would push the other one like this, you were so little. And I just remember seeing you, that little spot, looking through Flashman's yard from the front yard, seeing you just giving it back, getting over to Philip.
Do you remember how we used to go to their house?
Pardon me?
Do you remember how we used to get to their house?
We'd go down the street and turn the corner, we'd go through the flies, we'd go through those bushes, we'd run there.
Yeah, we'd go through their yard.
Do you remember those, like, vines?
We'd always run like hell, do you know where to see you doing this?
Okay,
I've forgotten all about that.
Do you remember their vines? We used to play Tarzan behind that little shed.
Yeah, they cut all those down, too. Yes. Every one of those. That was really cool. That wisteria that was free and grew around itself. And, I mean, it was like a big jungle gym in the middle of the woods behind their house.
Behind the Blacksmith?
No, behind Phillip's house.
Yeah.
There's all crazy places to play hide and seek back there. I remember, I don't know whose house it is, but you cross over, like, you're in the back alley, and you go across, like, this little bridge thing into the backyard, and it's, like, another land. It's, like, bushes and just... paths out.
I'm sorry. Right on the alley.
Stop.
You're waxing your hair. Like this.
That was. Oh, did you see that man?
I see him.
Good.
I don't like him.
I don't like him.
Have you seen the guy that smokes? Huh? This guy makes me want to throw up. It's so awful, but. At the same time, it's so absurd, and it seems like I've been waiting for something like this to happen because. Seems like more people will be doing this, but he'll come out and say, I smoke. So what? I love it. He just sort of, it's the silliest thing you've ever seen, but he does it over and over again. And just like, if people are trying to cut down, I'm trying to smoke more. You know? I thought y'all would have seen him. He's pretty big.
Wait, come here.
What?
You got this little fuzz and those curls. Like that goes that way. Got these little
extra bangs.
Scrub dogs.
That's dude.
They told me that the spot that they got married in was just a big brown spot where the grass wouldn't grow forever.
After that,
died back there.
Right in the very spot they were standing, Mikey, it turned brown.
Why is that?
Something in their feet.
I think they'll be fine for good. They're made for each other.
Is Tommy getting fat?
I think so.
I thought I saw her in the parking lot one day, and I wasn't sure it was her.
I wouldn't blame her. If she wanted to, I would say go right on. You know? It ain't like I was just keeping up in shape for her. And she doesn't need to be cruising for any guys anymore, so she's set. Go eat while he plays Nintendo and drinks wine. I'm sorry, he didn't drink anymore. No more. At all. He stopped like a year ago.
Can we see Mom?
She came up a couple months ago. Chuck and roll.
We saw her car today.
So what?
We saw the blue smoke behind it.
What car?
Her old car.
What old car?
She had no car. It was really, really right.
Laura got a car. I called her tonight. She's like, hello? She sounded really weird. I was like, hello? Hello. She's like, oh my gosh, you'll not believe this. She goes, I was laying here and I was all depressed because I miss you and I haven't seen you in so long and I just wanted to talk to you. And so I just got into my bed and I'm sitting here looking up at your card, reading it over and over again, thinking, God, I want to talk to Mandy and you call. She's like, that's really weird. Oh, anyway, that's not a good story. She got a car. She got an 81 Volkswagen Jetta. She said it's so cute.
Chest will on that.
One bad Jetta.
One bad 81. you haven't seen it yet. Have you seen it?
No.
Didn't see it.
No.
It's still all over town. The guy works at the...
What, one bad 84?
One bad 84. Where's you saw it.
No, I did.
You didn't? I thought you did when you were up.
I'm so confused.
Was it like a Chevette or something?
It was a Citation. It's white, and I hate it. Spotlight. I mean, everything that can be white is white on that car. Hubcaps.
It's a bad 81.
It's a bad 84. One bad 84.
I remember all license plates from all the cars we ever had.
She's an idiot sockman.
What?
Tell me, no, what was license plate to puke the bill?
JZE 944.
Uh-huh.
You go.
Oh, I'm not talking about the Olden. I don't know the Olden Dale is too old.
Well, there you go. That's the only one that counts.
That's a state mobile.
It was also the Pug mobile. You produced it.
Was it that car?
Oh, God.
Was it that car?
Your brand new coat is off.
Sat in a Houston airport parking lot for 2 weeks in the sun, but the windows rolled up. We come in over Houston, you can see this green.
New great drink.
A great drink and like 6 hard boiled eggs.
I said it was, you did right, it was that car. She goes, well, was your coat inside the school? Your new great drink.
That was terrible. I remember I was wearing this little jean jacket and I started feeling bad and I couldn't get my coat off. I was like, you know how like you get all uncomfortable?
That was rather uncomfortable.
We're going by this.
Yes, she did. She did. She threw up in the car and then got on the plane, but she went to sleep.
No one of these.
Sleeper.
That's where we were. We lived in Texas then?
When you threw up in the car.
I didn't know that.
Night before.
Here. Oh, the only thing I remember about that house was that pool on them. Corona was so cool.
What house?
No, wait, I'm talking about Mammy's house at Easter?
Your Mammy's place in South Carolina?
No, in Virginia.
The Verona went with her dude.
I know, but I remember, that's the only thing I remember from her Covington house was that Verona.
I don't remember that at all there.
Don't?
I do remember
it. It was in the little dining room.
Taking a leak in somebody's front yard.
Mom, get some bacon in the front yard.
I was just like,
well,
I'm still a child. I'm just going to keep out.
And that still does not beat Lowe's.
Shut up.
Lowe's lumber.
Dad, we're getting taped. Stop it.
No, I totally gave myself away. Tell me what.
You know that.
Oh, my God. When they told me this, I forgot all about it.
I don't remember it.
Mandy's 2 years old. She's getting potty trained.
Well, I was there.
The doctor.
Oh, Jesus.
The doctor says if she does it good, clap for her, tell her she's great. You know, make her a special
visit. I found it. Pardon me. I remember. I watched you doing it.
There's a little black boy watching me.
I'm so hard. I got the hell out of there. I was like, I'll come back. It's done. I gotta get away.
Oh, boy. You've never seen 4 people leave a strip club in your life. And Mandy's message remains.
I wonder if you had to clean it.
I don't know. Guarantee a lot of people quit over that.
Shit, you motherfucker.
Oh, my God. That's so funny.
I'm afraid, though, that they probably told somebody before. Somebody found it without having heard about it, you know? But it just a look on somebody's face. I don't know what I'm
yelling. Oh, Lord. And man, I'm so proud of herself. Look.
Tell you to come look.
Yeah, man. I would have never found it if she
hadn't. Oh, I remember looking at it. I remember seeing it.
That began
a long,
a long history of telling on yourself.
What do you mean?
Manny, don't be picking up dead animals. Don't be messing with strange dogs. Don't do anything with animals anymore. Okay. One day later, come home from work and Manny just says, hey, you know inside a squirrel's ear is all wet? I said, what? And see, I found a squirrel on my workbench out here, a dead squirrel. Looked like I had a heart attack. Nobody run over it. It's just a perfectly dead squirrel.
How the hell did you catch it, man?
It was dead. I remember I took it to Susie's house. I had it in my overalls right here. And she used to bury animals in her backyard.
But the squirrel wound up on the workbench. And I came home and there was a dead squirrel on the workbench. And I thought, God, she won't listen. She has to play a dead animal.
Roadkill Susie that she wants on her next car.
She had that on her bicycle. I was picking it up. And just out of the clear blue, just, you know, inside a squirrel's ear is wet. How would you know that?
Oh, I don't know. You said, I don't know?
Yeah, I don't know.
God.
That's like your hanky line swearing you didn't put it there.
Huh?
I walked by Mikey's room and I smelled something burning. And I opened the door and there's a hanky hanging on the light bulb from the ceiling. It's got a big brown spot. It's just ready to explode into flames.
I don't remember that.
Okay. What are you going to drive by? I didn't put it up there. I flew up there. I must have, because I didn't put it up there. You did. I didn't. I just didn't. 10 years later, we're laughing and talking, and Mike said, you know, one time I was just lying in my bed, I had this hanky, and I was throwing it up there, and stuff around the light. Oh.
I don't remember saying re-saying that to you.
Oh,
was that in your office?
No, I don't know. I don't remember where we were. We must have just been sitting and talking, because you just got right on the light. Oh.
Do you remember when you were up in the attic playing? You came downstairs and you started screaming because you had a wasp in your hair. You don't remember that?
I remember getting stung by a wasp up there.
We used to go there.
Put my hand on the bed and there's a wasp right there.
What's the name of Letterman list of
I think it's a Boy Scout.
Yeah, wasp nest licking. And number one, the board lick me, the board game.
So lick great. Me, the board game.
Lick me, the board game. You can go. It was Kate.
Okay. I don't want a cake. I know what I want.
You want no cake?
I don't know.
Where's that book? On the chest.
Kate?
Yeah.
Don't, just sit down. I'd like to do this.
Maybe
the initial
ball, then
you
didn't get any cut.
I know my feet.
You did.
I have to check underneath the sofa. Because he'll put his ball beans in his cheek.
I think let's put them up.
Top 10 most common New York City health code violation number 9. Rat in rice canister not wearing a hairnet.
Oh, God.
So read them out loud now when you get to the end. No, don't do that now.
Is this good?
I do want cake!
Oh, I saw a David Letterman book and it said, like watching TV in convenient book form. I thought that was real. Okay.
Dad doesn't like it when I'm pinching teeth.
Do you like it?
I'll pinch your nipple. Helpful. And pumps.
Tank of live lobsters with wet hacking coughs.
What kind of cake is
kitchen that? Kitchen full of shirtless fat guys soothing sunburns with raw veal.
What is the day of today? Today's Tuesday.
Raymond Burr's swimming trunks. You read them, haven't you? You haven't? Well, you've read the first one, I'm sure.
No, I've not read any of it, man. You just read it to us.
Al Sharpton's hot tub. Orville Redenbacher's top 10 horrifying secrets.
Orville's top 10 what?
Top 10 most horrifying secrets. That's not his grandson, it's his, quote, longtime companion. That's 50 pounds of plastic explosive taped to his body at all times. Came home and took one night to find his wife in bed with Keebler elves.
Top 10 findings of Zachary Taylor's autopsy. Mrs. Taylor was a very happy woman, if you know what I mean.
Oh my God. Old Redenbacher's horrifying secret, has small vestigial wings.
Has what?
Small vestigial wings. Oh, God, so gross. Likes to wear pants three sizes too large, go to malls, and then say oops whenever they fall down.
Who's that singing?
Top 10 ways to tell you possess. Number 4, you're a former cast member of Different Strokes.
Did you see the candles
on there? Number 2, you become Vice President of the United States even though you are a total boob.
I'm a boob, I'm a big fat boob. Did you see the candles on
there? Are these down?
No.
Ooh.
Hey. Oh my gosh. Oh, I got the letters! Yay! Ink.
Ink.
Look at all that stuff in there.
There's a lot of different stuff in there.
See, we got foliage all in here.
Ooh, what a little piece for Dad.
Dad's watching his...
What are we trying to say here?
Bernie's getting larger.
Jeez, this is so weird.
Here, I'm not sure.
Tricks you can play on census taker. You say, excuse yourself in the room and come back wearing different clothes many times. Have Tua and Fred hang out in the living room as he counts as one person or two. This is the funniest one, I think. Number 6, invite them to take a shower to freshen up, then keep flushing the toilet.
Invite a social taker to take a shower.
That was so absurd. That was absurd. All right.
Look out of the way. Look out.
What is this? Am I some kind of house epileptic or something?
Yeah.
All right, now.
I've been planning this for ages. What is prickly stuff? Pretty?
So do you think we should take Russell's present and all of us stand on the porch and knock on the door so you can open it and see what he looks like when he looks at it?
Yeah, we'll do that. I don't think they have company.
Falafel Bill.
I know.
Stop your hump.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, now see, this is something I like. Top 10 grounds for justifiable homicide. This is something I get into. Using CB lingo. Being a new kid on the block. Trying to start the wave. Repeatedly answering telephone. Yellow.
Yellow.
Eating all the crackling of bran. Constantly combing your hair. Constantly combing your hair and asking passerbys, do you think I look like Jack Lord?
Who's Jack Lord?
Oh my God, my life.
I'll get it.
Yellow.
storm.
Is the next storm from here?
Baskin Robbins will not be open.
Mm-hmm. You're not going to be the surplus tomorrow.
Hey, you can have it tomorrow, all right?
You don't want to run? No, I don't like it.
I love it. I'm just... I was full when I started eating it.
One left. And you got nine. Shoes. Hey, they match your shirt. What you were doing.
I know. Go.
I go? Okay. Wait a minute. I'll get it.
Yep, hold it in your hand as you bow.
I'm still doing it.
Well, hold it. Yeah, do that.
No.
Do it.
I can't afford a method.